So I originally purchased Project Cars 2 about 2 days after it was released. It was kind of difficult to play at the time. I thought it was because I had a controller, and it actually was. You have to mess with the settings a little bit in order to get the controller to work properly. And so I messed around for about 3 or so hours, going back and forth with the settings, and then I decided to watch a YouTube video about it and a couple other YouTube videos, and I found a sweet spot. And the game was playable on the controller. It was really playable. And so I went on from there. I initially bought the game to drive Indy cars. And I drove a lot of Indy cars. But I also drove a lot of other cars like GT cars, prototypes, vintage cars, whatever. The game was very much playable. That's the point I'm trying to get to you, that I could have easily driven it with a controller. But then the update happened. And my initial thought was that the update was going to go and fix some of the bugs that still happen with the game. Me being optimistic about it. It was a 7 GB update to that point. Well, after it downloaded, I jumped straight into a game with IndyCars. And I noticed the car drove a little bit different. It had a little bit more sway on the rear end. And the car was a little bit more skittish. The car is driving very unusual. The car is moving a lot more than it normally did, and the steering felt a little bit odd, to say the least. I thought that the update kind of changed the steering physical a little bit, and maybe I had to kind of readjust my controller settings a little bit more, because I did see inside the update notes that they did some physics change to some of the cars and how they handle. So me thinking, oh, let me just adjust my controller settings. The problem still insisted no matter how much I mess with this. By the way, I'm using a default setup, so there's no real excuse to why my car is acting out of control. And so, the more and more I tried to fix the problem, the more I got frustrated until I realized where the problem actually came from. The problem came from the fact that my tires were overheating inside about a lap. And so I did an experiment. I went and I recorded the footage of me doing one lap around the Indianapolis Motor Speedway road course with Indy cars. And you could see inside the footage that I take my lap. I pass a bunch of cars, don't mind that. But we focus on how the car is driving and how odd it's reacting to my steering inputs and how it looks more skittish and it sways a lot more than it normally should. We're still on the first lap, and you can see the tires starting to overheat as we come into the remainder of the lap coming onto the front straight. It gets worse and worse. The tough part about this and the frustrating part about this is that I'm using the default setup. Two, I'm using stability and traction control, which would limit this type of tire wear, as well as I have tire wear completely off. I know that with tire wear off, you still can get your tires up to temperature and the tires do still change temperature, but it doesn't explain how all four of them get so hot in one lap of a racetrack. You can see it again when I drive this LMP car, this prototype, and you could see after about 3 minutes, because this is a 20-minute race, it's time. After about 3 minutes, the tires, they get very, very hot. The car is a little bit more stable because it is a prototype and it's a little bit easier to drive than an Indy car. But you can definitely see a big change inside the tire temperature, even though it's about lap two. The part where you really see the big difference and you really see the problem is when I go to an oval at Texas Motor Speedway. I use a roughly default setup. I mess with the springs a little bit, mess with the downforce a little bit, nothing too out of the norm. But as I come into turn one, my car sways a little bit more to the left than is controllable, and I have to counter steer very much to the right. And so you could see through the course of the lap, I don't need to do any more explaining how difficult it actually is to drive. You can see, even though it's only about lap two, the car is undrivable. I cannot steer the thing properly. I'm going well below the pace, but yet my tires are overheating, and yet the car is borderline uncontrollable. With traction control and stability control, the two aids that are supposed to be helping me, some people might look at it and say, you're using stability and traction control, only noobs use that, that's why you're having the problem, you're using a default setup, you should try and use other setups. But the thing is, the default setup shouldn't break my car. Traction control and stability control, they may give me slight disadvantages, not that much on the traction control side. The stability control might give me a slight disadvantage, but it shouldn't be game breaking. As well as the fact that smoke piles out of the rear end of the car, and each one of these clips making it look like my car is broken, but that's actually the natural state of the car. I don't know what the Project Cars 2 team did with the update. I don't know if it's a problem on my end, but I very much think it's a problem on their end. I enjoyed Project Cars 2 a lot. I think it's one of the best racing games that I've played to date. I've played a couple other racing games, many different ones, and I think this one suits my driving style the best. But yet, after the update, it's unplayable. I want to play this game, but I cannot because of how bad the handling is. If you're from Project Cars 2, if you're from Slightly Mad Studios, or anybody who developed the Project Cars 2 game or still works on it, please fix this for me, or please help me with this situation. I really want to get back into your game and play it, but this is just borderline frustrating.